Hello everyone. Today we will discuss about the string functions, which comes in the under fifth unit of your course. Now, first we will see what is a string. String actually is a character array, simple and dumb you can say it, and which is terminated by the null character. Or the other type is string class is defined in C++. Usually string class is defined in Java, and you make the object of a string class and work with the string. String is actually one dimension array of characters which is terminated by the null characters. Null character terminated string constant, the character that comprise the string followed by the null. This is very much necessary because the strings are not all the time having equal size. If strings have different sizes, so how can we print the string only? So we have to terminate that string with the null character, and this facility is given by compiler automatically. If you assign a string, then compiler will place null character after the string automatically. If you are working with the characters, you have to place null characters manually. The following declaration initialization create a string consisting word hello. We are creating a string. You can see it. Character is a type. Character type, data type, and we are making a variable greeting and having 6 characters. Okay, now I'm initializing here only. So in the curly bracket, I am giving characters H, E, L, L, O and null character. Because I have given characters in single quotes, so you have to put the null character also. But if you write like this, character greeting, if this square bracket is hollow, means without any number, it means you have to initialize the word here and automatically it will define as the number 6. Because the word has 5 characters plus 1 character is null, automatically it will define 6. Now you can present in the memory. You can see how will it present in the memory. Every character has an address. You can see address here, 51, 52, 53, 54. Because a character takes a byte, the next byte is the next character. And the variable greeting, having 6 characters, you can define it with the help of index number 0 to 5, means 6. Greeting of 0 means H, greeting of 1 means E, greeting of 2 means L, greeting of 3 means L, greeting of 4 means O, and greeting of 5, 6 character is null character. So I think you understood that how memory allocated for the character array. You do not place null character at the end of string constant. If you are taking string in double quotes, you don't need to put null character. Compiler automatically places null at the end of string. Now you can see a simple example in C++, that is iostream.h and conio.h. And here I am counting or I am displaying an array. Here character array greeting having 6 characters, H, E, L, L, O, null character, and greeting message. This is output, and simply I am giving greeting. Only the name of variable greeting. Now it will print the whole word hello. Greeting means you can say greeting of 0, means it will start from the H and it will print till the null character will find. So it will print hello only. Now we can see there are so many types of string functions. Str copy, string copy function, which copies s1 to s1, s2 into s1. S2 into s1 means the s value of s1 is now after this function is s2. You can't assign it like s1 equals to s2. String not means array cannot copy like this. So you have to use str copy function, from where you can assign s2 into s2. There are two string variables, character arrays, s1 and s2. Now string cat means we are concatenating s2 in s1. Suppose s1 is hello and s2 is world. With this function, you will get hello world. Okay. Now, third is string length. It will count the length of string. Suppose I will give str s1 or str greetings, it will show 5 because hello having 5 characters. String comparison means it will comparing s1 means first string with s2 second string. If both string are same, it will return 0 to c. If 1 will return, it means the first string is greater. If -1 will return, it means the second string will be greater. In this example, the first string is greater because the ASCII value, it will compare with the help of ASCII value. The ASCII value of H is greater than the ASCII value of capital H. Okay, so the ASCII value of capital H, these are the ASCII value of A. By this you can count the ASCII value. B has 66 and 98, C has 67 and 99, like this. You can count and you can see that the smaller means lowercase character having more ASCII values, so it will give the +1. Now string CHR, it means this function will find CH, means a character inside the string. Suppose you have S1 means hello, and you want to find out the O is character. So it will show you 0, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. Fifth one character is the O character. It will show the first occurrence of character in the string. STR means like this above, we are finding the string inside the big string. Suppose S1 is a big string, that is I am a student of computer, and S2 is student. So you can get the occurrence of a student in S1. From which position, from which number, index number, it will show it. Means one string is finding inside the S2 string is finding inside the S1 string. I am a student of, suppose for example, I am a student of SIRT, and I want to find out this is equals to, I can say it S1, this is S1, and the S2 is student. So your answer will be the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. It will show at the position of 6th index, the student occur, showing the first occurrence. If there are so many time of students, you have to put it in nesting or next like this. OK. okay, so you are getting, you can see the there are different type of string functions and you can implement it by an example. Now I will show you simple example. There are two strings, str1, string1 and string2, and in string3 we can combine it also. Okay, I will show you here 20. Now string1 and string2, string1 has value hello, string2 has value 1. Okay, now what we are doing, string copy means we are copying string3. In string3 has no value, so we are copying string3 into string 3. We are copying string1 into string3. So what is the value of string3? Hello. And what is the value of string1 is also hello. You can see out it str3, you will get hello in answer. You can see here. Now the next function is string cat, means we are concatenating two strings str1 with str2. The value of str1 is hello and the value of str2 is world. Now you can see string1, the value of string1 is after concatenation is hello world. Now if you want to find out the string length of str1, so it will show you alien 10, because the hello world 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10, so 10 value will be counted here. You can see all the, you can discuss or you can implement all this type of string functions. You have to put one thing here, this is the header file for the string functions, means all string functions are defined or described in string.h file. So if you are using these type of functions, first please you put in your program string.h, then you will get the correct answer. With this, I am finishing this topic. We will see next topic in next lecture. Till then, goodbye.